Hey there everyone, welcome to another video of Fox Android. So in this video we're gonna learn how to implement navigation drawer along with the fragments using Java as the backend language, right? So we have already done this tutorial using Kotlin as the backend language. If you want, you can check out that video as well. I'll put the link in the description below, right? So what does this means, navigation drawer along with the fragments? So if you can see on my mobile screen, right, I have this hamburger sign on the top left corner. If I just tap on this, a navigation drawer opens up. Now if I tap on any item, for example if I just tap on home item, you can see in this activity itself the home fragment has been inflated in the view, right? So if I again open the navigation drawer, tap on message, the home fragment has been changed with the message fragment, and similarly with the settings fragment as well, right? So if you want to learn this and implement to your Android application, make sure you watch this video till the end. So without much ado, let's get started. So guys, if you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and press the bell notification icon for receiving the notification of the upcoming videos. And by the end of the video, if you like the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button as well. So guys, as you can see here, we have already implemented a navigation drawer, right? So if you know that how to implement a navigation drawer, then you can continue with this video. But in case you do not know how to implement a navigation drawer, then I already have a tutorial on that. You can watch that tutorial by clicking on this I button, and I'll also put the link in the description below, right? You can go and watch that video. And if you do not want to watch that video as well, I'll put the link for this boilerplate code, right? You can download that code and you will get this code, right? Then you can continue with this tutorial as well. So it is up to you guys, how do you want to continue? I have given you all the options. So to implement this thing, first we are going to add 3 fragments, right? So for that, just right click here on the app, new fragment, blank fragment, and let me just name it as home fragment. And similarly, I'll add 2 another fragments. So I'm adding only 3 fragments to save some time. So first we are going to go to the home fragment. So here, just to implement some design, I'll add a text view. So okay, we have implemented a basic design, we have added a text view, and we have set the background color for all the 3 fragments. Now we are going to go to our main activity XML file where we are going to implement these fragments, right? So here you can see I have a text view here, so I'll just simply delete this, and we are going to add a frame layout here, right? So this frame layout will be used to replace the fragments. So we'll set the height and width as match parent. We'll give it ID. So here you can see this is our frame layout. Now we are going to our backend code, right? We'll go to the Java file of the main activity, and here you can see whenever a user taps on any item of the drawer layout, we have just raised a toast, right? For example, if the user clicks on the home tab, the home is clicked, toast will be raised. So now to replace that frame layout with the fragments, we are going to create a new method. So let me just do that. So private void replace fragment, and it will take the fragment as an argument. Now inside this method, we are going to implement the code to replace the फ्रेम लेआउट विद द फ्रेगमेंट्स। So okay, this particular code will replace our frame layout with the fragment. So we have got the instance of our fragment manager, then we have got the fragment transaction, right? So here we have begin the transaction using dot begin transaction on the fragment manager, and here we have used fragment transaction dot replace r dot id dot frame layout. That means this particular layout will be replaced with the fragment that will be passed as an argument to this method. Then we have commit this transaction, right? So now we are going to call this method here whenever the user taps on this nav home tab. So we are going to call replace fragment and we'll pass the object of home fragment, right? And similarly we will do that for the message tab and settings. So okay, now when the user taps on this button, this method will be called. So one more thing we are going to do is we are going to highlight the item that is being clicked in the navigation drawer. So for that we'll use item dot set checked as true, right? So but there is some issue with this line. So whenever the user taps the different items, the old items will also be highlighted, so it will not work perfectly fine. So for that we'll just go to our menu. So you can see here we are going to add all these items inside a group tag like this group, and we'll set checkable behavior as single. So this particular line of code will make sure that only one item is highlighted at a given point of time. So okay, we have wrapped all the items inside this tag group and we have set the checkable behavior as single. So that is pretty much everything we need to do to implement this to our Android application. So now let me just quickly install this app to my cell phone and check if it is working fine or not, right? So okay guys, the app has been installed to my cell phone. As you can see on my mobile screen, if I just tap on this hamburger sign and select messages, so you can see the frame layout has been replaced with the message fragment and similarly with the home and settings as well. So I guess we have successfully implemented this feature to our Android application, and I also hope that you guys have understood the code. But still, if you have any doubt, you can always ask me in the comment section or you can DM me on Instagram. The Instagram username will be there on screen right now. And if you like the video, make sure to hit that thumbs up button, and in case you're new to this channel, make sure to hit that subscribe button and press the bell notification icon for receiving the notification of the upcoming videos. So that is it for today's video. See another video. Bye.